Today we'll be discussing some of the symptoms of breast diseases and the related investigations. So the most common symptom for any breast disease is lump in the breast. It may or may not be associated with pain in the breast. And some of the other symptoms can be either a nipple discharge or any change in size, shape or texture of the breast, any lump in the armpit, or any unusual change in the breast which was not there before but has happened now, that could be a cause for concern. So if any of these symptoms happen, ladies, please go to your nearest doctor and get it checked out. Please understand that majority of these symptoms occur in benign conditions. Benign means non-cancerous. In fact, almost 90% of all breast lumps are non-cancerous. So it's very important to realize and understand that. And the most important thing is that you have to get them checked, you have to get them investigated. Don't be scared or don't be fearful about the investigations or going to the doctor part. It's really not very worrisome. And amongst the investigations, the most common investigations that will be done for you are mammography or a sonography of the breasts. Mammography is usually done in older women above 40 to 50 years of age, and sonography is usually done in younger women. That's because the breasts are very dense, and if we do mammography for younger women, then the density of the breast does not allow any small lesions to be picked up on mammogram. That's the reason they are advised a sonography first. So as I mentioned, mammography is the first line of investigation in older women. And as you know, this is a digital world, so a digital mammography is considered to be better than the routine film screen mammography. There are several reasons for that. There is better contrast resolution, minute details can be picked up, images can be zoomed in, images can be digitized, they can be stored, and overall the sensitivity of digital mammography is much better than that of the routine old traditional film screen mammography. That's the reason we always advise ladies to insist on getting a digital mammography done. Then after a mammography, many patients would be advised to undergo a sonography also. Please understand the information given by mammography and given by sonography can be different and can be complementary to each other. These tests are not alternatives for each other, but they can be complementary to each other. So both the tests might be required in many of the patients. And ultrasonography also, as I mentioned, a good high resolution ultrasonography along with an elastography is preferred modality of investigation to get a better diagnosis. Now once these investigations are done, your doctor will tell you whether or not you need a core natal biopsy. In case you need a core natal biopsy, again, as I say, do not get scared. It's not a very big procedure. It's a minor procedure done under local anesthesia on OPD basis. It takes barely about 5 minutes to do. You're given a little prick of local anesthesia and the whole area becomes numb, and then a core needle is inserted into the breast lump and few cores of tissue are taken. Please understand, there is no cut, there are no stitches, it's not a very big procedure, it's not something that's going to pain a lot. So it can be done quite easily. The results are available in generally 3 to 4 days, and then based on your results, your doctor will advise you regarding the treatment modality that may be required for you. Amongst the results, the most common diagnosis will be maybe a fibroadenoma. It could be complex cysts, could be hamartomas, could be sclerosing adenosis, fat necrosis, radial scars. These are all medical terms, but they are all benign lesions. That means they are all non-cancerous lesions. So as I said, 90% of the times these breast lumps are non-cancerous and there's nothing to get scared about. Just getting a correct diagnosis is important. In the rare case that it turns out to be a cancer, again your doctor will advise you regarding the correct modality of treatment for you depending upon the stage of your disease.